From my side, I have no doubt, and I'm very proud of myself that I met the Munkacs Rebbe after the war. Because you know, the Satmar Rebbe and the Munkacs Rebbe was taken out from the day when they arrived Auschwitz, they was taken over to Zurich.
Yeah, the Zionist custom took them.
Who did it? Not this is the point. But the point is, there's Baruch Rabinovich, who became the rabbi, the chief rabbi in 1939. Because the old rabbi, Shapiro, he passed away. So the new rabbi, he came from Poland. And he has to do the same what the previous rabbi have done, to learn, to study to go in the same way. But what we didn't know, and I didn't know, so from Zurich, he went to New York. And all the Hasidim from America was, and suddenly it was in 47 already. He had a big many Hasidim, and he told the Hasidim, listen, we did a mistake. We have to go to Israel, the place where we belong. So if I am going to Palestine, if you are going with me, it's okay. So what happened, more than the half became against him. So he went away from there to São Paulo, Brazil. So he met Ben-Gurion. And Ben-Gurion promised him, if you are coming to Israel, you are going to be the chief rabbi in Tel Aviv. And he never became in Tel Aviv. He was only in Cholon, in Petah Tikva. But anyhow, and suddenly I got known that I still have the forwards, the Yiddish newspaper, and the Yiddish newspaper from Israel. I used to have the Letz Tanayis and all those things, and I found out, oh my God, the rabbi, he changed his mind. So I came, and when he went, he came here and became rabbi in Cholon. He built up a beautiful, nice synagogue. And so he did a terrible mistake, and the mistake was his wife, Rochele, I remember very well, she passed away. So he got married with the lady who was helping in the house, for the help. And this a rabbi should never do. So even his children was against him. But anyhow, so I came in contact with him, and he told me that he was a Chinese, when he came from Poland, he was Chinese, he feels that's the only way. But so we became very friendly, we had a very good contact until he passed away for 7-8 years ago.
Because he just started recording, so I just want to ask you one other more general question. Looking back now on your life, which has been, traumatic and yet, as you say, in the ultimately successful and happy, what are the lessons that you have learned? What is the lesson of Siget, of the Holocaust? Have we learned the lessons?
I think yes. I think that Judaism around the world never had such a period what we have today. Never in the Jewish history you will find a period where no pogroms, and if it's something, then they get back. If it's Entebbe story, if you remember this, we have already a state what we can look look till, not as an as a power, but also who can give cultural inspiration and so on and so on. And this is what goes on. Take a look. No, the anti-Semitism in Norway. Norway is the big anti-Semitism in the whole world. The opposite is true. So I'm very against the media when they are just selling because they have to sell. I'm in business myself. I know how to run this. But you never tell a story. To give an example, now I'm speaking about Norway because they asked me the same in Norway about anti-Semitism in Norway. So I'm going over to another subject. Halavai around the world would be so much anti-Semitism like in Norway. You have so many organizations around the country where non-Jewish at all, and they are just support Jewish and Israel. We have organizations who are sending 10 million shekel every year, collecting the money in Norway to help Yod Neyem, this in Norwegian, but help the Jewish home in Russia. So they went to the Russian people, you have to go to Aliyah, and I'm paying your expenses. Where do you have people, where do you find them? I meet them, I know them. I used to give a lecture for them about Judaism. So in, I'm still working in, I'm leading my firm, but without this, I have a lot of foredrag, what you say, lectures, what I was even at university in Oslo or in Bergen or in meetings or whatever, and I'm telling about Judaism back. You will never find such a beautiful, nice spirit what we have here today.